decided to lay back and see what the
strong whale will do next. In 24 hours, everyone went from absolute euphoria to a pessimistic resignation. He is near Decker Island tonight, well back upstream. Willie Monroe with the big letdown.
Marine biologists have been frustrated by Humphrey's tendency to lose ground. The pipe banging herding technique is working. The problem is they have to stop after a while.
Time is limited by daylight hours, and we can drive this animal about 14 miles max during daylight hours. And I believe the operation is so complex that it's unsafe at night.
Mm-hmm.
And if we don't have a way to contain him, and we don't have a way to contain him at night, unless he stays where we put him the night before, there's no point in continuing the next day.
They are also afraid that repeated herding will cause the 40-ton mammal too much stress. So for now, that effort is called off. Tomorrow, scientists will try to attach a device that will allow them to track Humphrey by satellite, something that will be more useful after he leaves the inland waterways.
One of the reasons we're excited about the possibility of putting a tag on is to find out whether, after all of this, Humphrey makes it or not, frankly. We'll know whether he gets to a breeding area. We'll equally know if he washes up on a beach somewhere. As tragic as that might be, the information would be valuable in a future situation like this.
Efforts to monitor and herd the whale have nearly exhausted the $50,000 allotted by the state and federal governments. The cost would be even higher if it weren't for the many volunteers. Private contributions for this effort have been offered and are encouraged. But with the animal's unpredictable behavior, no one is certain just how much it will ultimately cost to save the whale. In Rio Vista, Willie Monroe, Channel 7 News, tonight.
And we can tell you that another experts meeting is scheduled for Thursday. One possibility, trying to keep him moving for 24 hours. In other words, overnight, instead of stopping as the sun goes down. And there'll be more on all of this on Nightline immediately following this newscast.
Rescuers and the concern of millions. But is that enough to save Humphrey, the humpback whale? Good evening. I'm Charles Gibson, and this is Nightline. For almost 2 weeks, whale experts have tried desperately to coax Humphrey the whale back to sea and safety. We'll talk tonight with the federal official heading that effort and with one of the world's foremost authorities on whales. Also tonight, probably nothing draws human sympathy like a vulnerable animal, an injured bird, a little kitten in a tree, or apparently a 40-ton whale. For 2 weeks, the scientists have simply been stumped about how to get a humpback whale out of the Sacramento River in California, where in time, the freshwater environment...
It's really very simple.
...times most baffling creatures. As Ken Kashiwahara reports, the California case points out how little is really known about them.
Humphrey the humpback whale kept cruising up and down the Sacramento River today, still about 40 miles from the Pacific Ocean, still refusing to go home. Like all intelligent mammals, whales migrate south for the winter. In the Pacific, it is an annual trek from Alaska to Mexico or Hawaii. That's what Humphrey was doing earlier this month when he made a wrong left turn, turning east under the Golden Gate Bridge. There, on October 11th, he was spotted basking in San Francisco Bay, frolicking among the freighters. Experts were baffled. Normally, humpback whales never get lost.
This is extremely unusual. I've never heard of a humpback coming back this far.
So they tried herding Humphrey back to the ocean. Scientists gave chase in boats and helicopters. But the wayward whale kept wandering up a river instead, getting stuck on a sandbar at one point. A tugboat was called in to help nudge him off.
Looks like we got him turned the right direction, maybe. Which direction is the right direction? Towards the ocean, I hope.
But it was the wrong direction. Whales have an acute sense of hearing, so scientists tried playing underwater sounds of a killer whale.
The killer whale is a natural enemy of the humpback whale, and we hope that by playing these sounds, the animal will turn around and move downstream.
But that didn't work either. Neither did sounds of soothing music. The meandering mammal kept meandering upstream. Whale experts began to wonder why.
Perhaps Humphrey just wandered upriver to feed. Perhaps he's brain damaged. Perhaps he's insane.
Finally, after a week of behaving like a salmon swimming upstream to spawn, Humphrey settled down in a narrow inlet 60 miles from the ocean, and scientists decided to leave him alone for a while. By now, the wrong-way whale had become a river phenomenon. Thousands flocked to the river banks, some speculating about why Humphrey was here.
Scenic tour.
Others expressed concern.
I think it's very sad. I don't think he'll get out of it.
The whale even wandered into classrooms, his tale chronicled in song.
So swim, you whale, to the ocean. Swim, you whale, to the sea. Swim back home, you humpback whale, out to the ocean deep.
Everyone tried to picture a way to get Humphrey home.
The people are getting fish and throwing it out to the whale, and the whale is following it to the ocean.
California Marine Mammal Center.
Marine biologists received thousands of suggestions from the public, such as
net him and lift him with a helicopter, tow him out, put him on floating docks and tow him out, tranquilize him.
Scientists said any of those suggestions were either impractical or might hurt the 40-ton whale. But biologists decided a week in the freshwater inlet might hurt Humphrey too, and decided to use a scare tactic. Banging the pipes transmits low-frequency underwater sounds designed to scare the whale downriver. But Humphrey simply refused to swim under a small bridge and was clearly irritated by the sound.
Okay, let's back up. Let's back up. Everybody back up.
But the irritation was temporary, biologists said. Remaining in the freshwater was worse.
That makes it too heavy, and it also tends to cause real problems with their skin, where pieces of it will slough off ultimately, and the animal will simply die.
So after dredging the river bottom to make more room for the 45-foot whale, rescuers tried again and succeeded.
Okay.
Scientists thought Humphrey was finally heading home, but Humphrey had other plans. In the darkness, he slipped by all the rescue boats, eluded the flares fired above the water. By morning, Humphrey was almost back to the inlet where he began. Biologists attached a radio transmitter to keep track of him, but it didn't work, and they plan to attach another. This past weekend, Humphrey's pattern has been moved downstream during the day, swim back upstream at night. Today, scientists said they were frustrated.
We were so enthusiastic and happy that we attained our goal last night.
Sure.
It was a real letdown to find him back up there this morning.
So this evening, officials have decided to suspend all efforts to move the whale, deciding both they and Humphrey have had enough, at least for a while. Ken Kashiwahara for Nightline in San Francisco.
And when we come back, we're going to be joined by two marine biologists involved in the effort to get Humphrey back on track. Kenneth Norris of the University of California, described by his peers as the world's leading authority on whales. And Jim Lecky of the National Marine Fisheries Service, the top federal official in charge.
This